You're watching Fox 29. This is Good Day Philadelphia.
Listen to this. A Delaware man and his wife are suing the hospital of the University of Pennsylvania over a refusal for treatment.
Now, Marcus Murray is blind and has brain damage. His lawyer says it's a result of HUP turning him away because he didn't have any health insurance. The couple's lawyer, Tom Klein, joins us now. Tom, explain the case more clearly for our viewers.
Marcus Murray was a man who was having a dissecting problem with his aorta. It was a tear in his aorta. It was an emergency. He reported to Underwood Hospital at 7:30 p.m. He didn't get treatment till 3 a.m. That's 8 hours later. While we believe Underwood delayed in getting him to HUP, a key element in the case is that at HUP, they accepted Mr. Murray as a transfer because they have the ability to treat a patient like Mr. Murray. They could provide the cardiothoracic surgery that he needed. They accepted him. They set up a bed. They set up an operating room. They billed him. They sent a collection agency after the bill. And they didn't provide the treatment. And the reason they didn't provide the treatment, which is documented right in the Underwood records, is that they said yes at 10:30 at night and no at 11:30 at night because he didn't have medical insurance. And it says right in the records that a physician at Penn said to the Underwood physician, Penn is not now accepting him after they did accept him because he doesn't have medical insurance. There is a federal law which says that an institution can't do that.
I'm just going to ask you that. When I go, if I go into the hospital and, my arm is about to fall off, gosh, I don't have any insurance. What is the procedure for hospitals across America?
Mike, there's actually a sign in every emergency room that says if you're in active labor, if a woman's in active labor, or you need emergency care, a institution that is able to provide that care cannot, quote, dump you, cannot not provide that care. So that if a institution that can provide specialized services, emergency care or emergency services, turns you away, they are breaking the
Why
law.
Why do you think they turned him
There's
away?
There's a federal law.
This is a good hospital. I mean, it has a great reputation.
Penn has a great reputation. It's a great institution. I said that last night on Fox. Mm-hmm. And the shame here is that they turned him away. But I know one thing. The medical record from Underwood, not Penn's medical record, but the medical record from the institution that was sending him, a nurse, who obviously knew what was going on and who obviously wanted to state it in the medical records, says, talk to doctor, one doctor at Underwood, talk to the doctor at Penn. Patient not accepted due to no medical insurance.
Is this a screw up or against, you think there's malice here?
Well, it appears to be a conscious decision. It's not, I don't want to attribute malice because I haven't talked to the doctor. I plan to take his deposition, sit down with him under oath and find out the answers. Mm-hmm. But the medical records clearly speak to the issue. I've been doing this 30 years, Mike, and it's very unusual that you see what was actually being thought, said, and then recorded in a medical record.
Well, we have a statement from the University of Pennsylvania, the hospital here. It says, we believe Mr. Klein's allegations are groundless, and they go on to say, we have expedited admission criteria for such life and death cases and accept patients without any regard to insurance coverage based on the urgency of their condition. So it kind of points to what you were just talking about. They say if it's an emergency, they don't turn anyone away. That's the bottom line.
Chanel, they know that, and that is the law, and they have to do that. Unfortunately, Penn doesn't have the medical records yet that I have. I have the Underwood Hospital medical records. At Underwood Hospital, which was trying to send the patient to Penn desperately, they say in black and white, in no uncertain terms, patient refused due to lack of insurance. The record which I provided to Fox and which I believe has already been shown on TV actually says that. That's the glaring thing that we have here in this case. That's the quote smoking gun.
And what happened to the patient?
Unfortunately, Marcus Murray today, who was a man who went out to work supporting his family, a man from Delaware, contractor, laborer, is now blind. He is neurologically damaged. He can't take care of himself. And he's horribly, horribly injured. He needs lifetime care. And that's what the suit's all about, Mike.
When do you go to court?
We filed the suit today, and the federal court in Philadelphia, since this is a federal a question here, the federal courts are very timely. I would expect a trial within the year.
All right, Tom, thanks for that.
No shortage of talkers this morning. All right.